From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Four men arrested during a prostitution sting in Cumberland County are due in court today to enter a plea. They were part of a group of 11 people arrested back in August.
News 8's Sama Ponton has more for us.
The four men scheduled to enter pleas today were arrested as part of a two-month-long undercover sting operation involving four separate agencies. The Cumberland County Sheriff's Department, along with police from Yarmouth, Brunswick, and Bridgeton, arrested 11 people back in August. Authorities placed phony ads on Craigslist and Backpage.com. More than 150 people responded to the phony ads. The police arranged to meet the people who responded at a hotel where they were arrested. Now, the four people scheduled to enter pleas today include Chad Roper, Joseph Miller, also Eric Van Savage, and Spencer Ritchie. All are charged with engaging a prostitute, and they are scheduled to be arraigned later this morning at 8:30. We will continue to follow this story and keep you updated later today on News 8 and on our website, WMTW.com. For now, from Portland, I'm Tama Ponton, News 8 Now.
Well, two men accused in a Lewiston home invasion are expected to enter a plea in court today. 22-year-old Kevin Stitchell and 19-year-old Ricardo Hairston are both charged with robbery. Stitchell is also facing additional charges for violating his bail conditions. Police say that the men forced their way into a Pierce Street apartment with a double-barreled shotgun and a handgun, robbing a man inside of his medical marijuana.
A man charged in connection with a triple murder in northern Maine last year is due in court today for a hearing to revoke bail. Robert Stroud has pleaded not guilty to charges of hindering apprehension and arson. Court papers say Stroud helped Thane Ormsby after the killings in Amity in June of 2010. Ormsby facing three counts of murder for the stabbing deaths of Jeffrey Ryan, Ryan's 10-year-old son, and a neighbor, Jason DeHaan. Court papers say Stroud told detectives he took Ormsby to a field where Ormsby set Ryan's truck on fire, then helped him dispose of a knife and also drove him to New Hampshire. A former bus driver who worked in Maine and New Hampshire is due in federal court in New Hampshire today to face child pornography charges. John Allen Wright is also facing two gross sexual assault charges in Maine. Wright's accused of sexually assaulting a six-year-old disabled boy on a school bus while taking him to summer school in Kittery. He was arrested in New Hampshire where he lives last month during an online child pornography sting.
A Massabesic High School teacher is free on bail today after her arrest on charges of gross sexual assault. 36-year-old Jessica Palmerlow, a special education teacher for RSU 57, is accused of having a sexual relationship with a 15-year-old former student. She's also facing charges of aggravated unlawful furnishing and of scheduled drugs. York County Sheriff's deputies say that she also provided marijuana to a student. Deputies say that the parents of another student is the ones who brought these allegations forward. Palmerlow, who is from Limerick, had been working for RSU 57 for 4 years.
Verso Paper says it's planning to shut down a paper machine at its mill in Bucksport, putting about 125 people out of a job. Paper company says it's shutting down one of its machines for good October 23rd. Mill currently runs four machines and has more than 700 workers. Verso says demand for the paper it produces, which is mostly magazines and catalogs, has been falling.
And thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. We'll see you in a few minutes with much more.